Why is model deployment so hard? Whenever we talk about model deployment, people keep saying flask it. It's easy, right? Just put it in a Python flask app and it starts serving the users. Is it that easy? Why do they then call it as a last mile challenge? And sometimes like model deployment takes more time than the entire model training life cycle. So what are we missing in the puzzle when people really say like model deployment is as easy flask it, right? When we talk about model deployment, you need to think of one aspect, right? Model deployment is not the model algorithm alone. It is not only a TensorFlow protobuf file, or it's not only a scikit-learn pickle file. It's a combination of the entire pipeline that you need to deploy. It can be your data collection pipeline. It can be your feature engineering pipeline. It can be the model algorithm itself. And it is also the post-model monitoring aspect of it, right? That is one thing. Now, when you are developing a model, you may use some of the variable that resides in a batch system. You need to take the data in from the batch system and put it into a different data store altogether to meet your latency requirement. That is the second aspect of it. Flask is fine for where you are not very latency sensitive, but think about application where you need to deploy a model in a real-time streaming pipeline and you want like 10 millisecond or 20 millisecond response time. It's very difficult to flask an app at that time, depending on the use case and the complexity of pipeline type. Sometimes in-streaming model deployment may work better. The second aspect is you need to kind of deploy it in the edge of the device, or you want to deploy closer to the device. Say it is an IoT device and you want to action as soon as an anomaly happens. At the time, you cannot make an external REST service call, or there may be the device might not be connected to the internet. So you basically have to deploy the model within the IoT device. The other aspect that comes into play, the latency. You may have to score like a million transactions per second. Just deploying it on one server may not help. You have to scale out in the hundreds of servers to meet your latency, meet your non-functional requirement. There are a lot of aspects that come into play when we talk about model deployment. And sometimes like you may have to completely remodel or redesign your model to fit into a target language that the business process supports, to be closer to the business process and to be embedded into the business process. Again, you need to take the model that is developed in Python and maybe you have to put it into Java or something, or C++ or something like that. You may have to sometimes deploy in batch where you might have to like kind of at the month end life cycle, you have to forecast hundreds of millions of transactions within an hour or two so that it's live, and it's kind of, you may have to pass it on to your partner or downstream application. So there are a lot of aspects that come into play in model deployment. While 85% of the typical models, it might be easy to just flask it, the entire pipeline, but the 15% is where the real challenge comes. And it's very important to understand what are the various way you can deploy a particular model to make it to make like real-time prediction. What I'm going to do in the next series of video is talk about model deployment. I'm going to talk about the challenges of model deployment, what are the different ways you can deploy a model, and then we will go into the further in the life cycle of model monitoring and recalibration of the model. Thank you.